Hi guys, how are you doing? So I'm Krishna, developer advocate here at OpenAI. So let's understand the prompt management. Why do we need a prompt manager, right? I believe prompt engineering is pretty much important than programming. You know, that's what NVIDIA's CEO said, and I agree. So when you're building a lot of systems powered by AI or built by AI, you need to know how the prompting works, right? So you have to use a lot of prompting techniques, a lot of prompts, complex prompts involving a lot of variables. So that's not an easy task, you know, organizing all of these prompts, validating them, testing them. It'll be very hectic. So we need a prompting manager or prompt management tool. So that's what we'll be talking about today. So OpenAI has a prompt management tool available on the platform. So that's basically is the solution for what we are thinking right now. So in this video, in this tutorial, I'll be explaining you how we can use this prompt management tool to create prompts, to update them and to test them, right? And also we have API available as well for the prompt management. So I'll also explaining you how to create or manipulate all of these prompts through the API calls as well, right? So this will be an interesting video. So without any delay, let's get started. Go to the prompt management and you can see this particular screen here. So for now, I don't have any prompts, right? So I'll create a new prompt. But before creating a new prompt, let's understand, why do we need prompt management, right? Do we need it? So the answer is yes, definitely we need it, because prompt engineering has been developing so rapidly, right, nowadays. I mean, so any engineer has to know how to prompt properly, you know, to build any AI-powered engines, AI-powered systems, right? So the prompts can be very complex. They can have many variables. So it's quite frustrating to test them, to validate the prompts, and also to store them in an organized way. So we need to have a prompt manager which can do all of these, you know, to handle different prompts, to test various variables we have in the prompts, and see if the particular LLM is able to understand the prompts or not. So this prompt management tool we have here on the OpenAI platform handles everything, well, everything that I'm discussing. So let's see this in action on the platform for now. So I'll create a new prompt. Okay, so for now I'll just create, I'll use the same example prompt they gave. Translate this word to probably French. And don't forget to name your prompt and make sure there are no spaces. So for now it's basically, translate prompt, something like that. Translate this word to French, and this is a variable. I mean, this is pretty straightforward, it's very simple, but the prompts can be too complex, right? They can have many variables. You can, it's not that easy to test them if you don't have a proper tool, right? And the response format, it's JSON. JSON format is pretty good enough for this. And you can check the response format documentation you have powered by OpenAI. So they have some models support specifying a response format in JSON schema. So if you want to have a different format, you can actually specify it here, right? So so let's create the prompt now. Oh, so before that you have to select an LLM. I'll select 3.7 Sonnet, that's my favorite. This is for testing purpose, so let's create a prompt now. Okay, so the prompt has been saved. Okay, so as soon as the prompt gets saved, you can see a new section saying variables. Variables are nothing but these, right? For now, we have only one. Okay, so it says, okay, word is a variable. So you can type a particular word there. For example, you are welcome, something like that. Okay. And if you test prompt, so yeah,
So you are welcome. In French is de rien, okay, or this, and these are all the common ways to respond, right? So the thing is, in the back end, behind the scenes, so this prompt will be translated to like this, right? Translate this word to French. You're welcome, right? So that's how the prompt is. That's how the variables work. So this is how you can test on the platform. But what if you want to, you know, create a new prompt from the project itself, right? Without going to the platform, test everything from the project itself. We can do that using the API. So they have, specified some of the APIs where you can create prompts. You can list all the prompts available. You can delete them. You can play around, right? So we'll be exploring that as well. So before that, let's head into the documentation section once and see what are the different params we have and the calls we can make, right? So let's do that. Okay, so we are on the documentation section here. So if you scroll down from here to here, you can see there's something called custom prompts. And these are the endpoints you have and you can use them. So list prompts is the first one. So it basically lists on all the prompts. So most of them are self-explanatory, so I don't need to specify why we are using it. And even the query params are also quite self-explanatory. So, okay, so the query params you can mention are the page and the page size. And then there are some prompts that are like very important for like, for example, create prompts. This is where you actually can create prompts from your backend. So so you have to provide the name. Just think of the platform, how we created prompts, right? So you need a name, you need text with variables like this, right? And then you need something like the model, you know, because you need to test it, right? So and then finally, a small JSON saying the temperature and max tokens that has to be generated, right? So again, it's self-explanatory, right? So on your right side, if you're working on Python, click on Python and you can see a small code snippet, you can use it. So this is good enough for a starter. You know, you just copy the snippet and paste it in your JSON and that's it, it'll start working. And there's something called get prompt. So if you have that one particular prompt name, you can get the details of it just by get prompt. And almost everything is like the same. Update prompt. So you can modify the existing prompt using the update prompt. Right? You can delete a prompt with this. So the base URL seems to be common, right? The API in AI.trans v2 prompts, right? So till here, the base URL is like same. So slash this getting changed. Right? And this is a prompt history. You can see the prompt history list. And you can delete them as well. You can update the prompt history as well. So I have created a fast API application using all of the prompts, prompt endpoints we have here. And I'll be showing it to you right now. So how I have made it. So nothing, there's no innovation in the project. Most of the code, the endpoints you can see are pretty much, you know, snatched from here. So that's pretty much it about the params end. So let's dive into the code base and see how I have implemented the fast API server for this, for the prompt management. So this is the fast API project that I was talking about. It's pretty much self-explanatory. So I have imported all the libraries and then of course we need hidden AI's API key. So I got it. If you don't know how to retrieve the API key, there's a dedicated video available, especially for API keys and billing and monitoring, right? So please check that out. We have also added the base URL, which I was mentioning before. api.ai.run/v2/prompts is the base URL, and on top of this we call our endpoints, right? Okay, so I define the app and the course middleware, and define the headers, and then so here comes the main game, right? So the first one is basically to list all the prompts we have. It's /v2/prompts, and if you see, I'm getting the response from the OpenAI's base URL, right? and these are the params that we have. If you've remembered the documentation, right? So we have some parameters, so we can use the same parameters here directly. So this is not there's nothing innovative about this here. So because I pretty much took everything from the snippet, and I modified it as per the as per my project requirements, right? Okay, so how can we create a prompt? So this is the endpoint, /v2/prompts again, and here we are posting, right? It's a post request, so to the base URL, and basically it's a JSON, right? So and we are passing the body. So that's pretty much it, and then we can get a specific prompt as well. Once we store or create the prompts with a name, you can retrieve a particular prompt using the name, right? So it's the same call, get call, we'll be using. And similarly, we can call a prompt and then update a prompt using a put request, right? So using a patch request as well, and then you can delete the prompts as well, right? So we can also see the prompt history endpoints. So it's basically based on the name, and then you can see the history. Also you can delete them, you can update them, you can update the same prompt history with the ID we have. So whenever we create a prompt history, so the response you get has ID in it, right? So you can use the same ID to update or delete or even retrieve, right? So that's pretty much it. That's how we basically do it. Even with the delete, if you see, you basically have the name and the ID, and that's it. You can delete the prompt history as well. So all of the operations that can be done on the platform can also be done through the APIs as well, right? And building systems require this sort of convenience, right? So let's see this in action. So so instead of running all the endpoints, I'm gonna run the important ones, right? So this is a prompt that creates basically, this is an endpoint that creates the prompt, right? So I just named the prompt as translate prompt probably two, and then translate this word to the language and the word, right? And I'm using GPT-4o, right? And then so let's send this and see. Okay, done. So we got the ID and we got the translate prompt too. Fun fact, of course, you can, once you create a prompt, you can see the changes in the platform as well, right? So you can go for a hybrid approach. You can create a prompt here, you can update from there, or you can create a prompt there and you can update from here. You can delete from there or you can delete from here. So it's based on the convenience and flexibility, right? Okay, so we created a prompt, and then let's go and see the prompt history. If you click send, you can see there are two prompts. This was the one I created before, I guess. So this is the new one, I guess. This endpoint is basically to update. So I change this to French, to probably the language you choose and the word, right? And probably just to 7. And then I'll just send. Okay, that's it. It worked. So that's how you basically use the APIs endpoints to manipulate the prompts, right? So similarly, you can use the other endpoints as well, like the to delete, you know, and to check the prompt history as well. So that's pretty much it. And let's go to the platform to see if whatever we have created are available or not, right? So you can see the prompts, the new ones which we've created using the API here. So for example, you can see, yeah, so the version 3 has been created, right? The from French to any language that you select, right? So you can again choose the different versions here and play around with that and create new version or use the new version and then add your variables and you can test the prompt, right? So that's what I was mentioning. You can do the both hybrid approach. You can create prompts there, edit here, you know, play here, test here, delete from there. So it's quite flexible. So that's how you basically manage all the different prompts using prompt management tool available on the Eden AI platform.
So that's the tutorial, guys. I hope you have liked it, you have enjoyed it. If you do, thank you so much. Please don't forget to like the video. If you have any comments to share, feel free to use the comment section. And if you have any concerns, don't forget to join the Discord. We are very active on the Discord channel. There's a help section in the Discord, so you can raise your queries there. So I'll reach out to you. And please subscribe because we'll be releasing new videos every week. So these videos will be quite helpful if you're planning to use Eden AI. So thank you again.